Welcome to the Misconceptions tutorial. In a previous tutorial, we looked at this picture showing how the Earth is going around the Sun, and we talked about how in your everyday thinking, you might assume that the reason the seasons change has to do with how far from the Sun the Earth is. And we talked about the fact that that's not true, that's just what your brain assumes by looking at this picture. However, if you spend time and look at it more scientifically and really investigate the problem, you begin to realize that it can't be how far you are from the Sun. Because if that were the case, then there'd be two winters and two summers, because there are two places in this picture where we look close to the Sun and two places in this picture where we look far away from the Sun. And since that's not what happens in real life, the observations that we have in real life don't match up with our explanation. And so that's what we would call an invalid theory of the seasons. It's not a valid theory. It doesn't match our observations. So we can't say that that's what causes the seasons. In reality, what causes the different seasons is that the angle of the sunlight is changing as we go around the Earth. When we're on this side of the Earth over here, we're tilting out of the Sun. You can see that our axis points this way. And since we're pointed away from the Sun in the Northern Hemisphere, the sunlight sort of glances off of us instead of us hitting us directly. And that means we get less direct sunlight, and the sunlight that hits us is never directly overhead, and so it's cooler. And as we move to this side, by the time we get to summer, we're tilting into the Sun, so the sunlight hits us much more directly, and it's more intense, and so it's hotter. And then over here in the fall and in the spring, we're getting neither direct nor indirect sunlight, so we're actually getting neither hot nor cold temperatures as a result. Why do I bring this up again for a second time? Well, it's important for you to know what causes the seasons, that's true, but that's not the reason I'm telling you about this. I'm telling you about this because the tendency that people have to make assumptions and jump to conclusions causes what we call in science misconceptions. Misconceptions are wrong or incomplete ideas or explanations about anything. And they're very, very common because, as we talked about previously, the human brain is designed to solve problems, but we're designed to do it quickly and in the moment. And so we don't always think things through as much as we could. We don't always use the scientific method. The scientific method is actually a tool for overcoming misconceptions. It's a way to avoid making assumptions and really get at the truth. One of my favorite misconceptions of all time is this one. Have you ever heard this? It has been said, I've heard it said many times, even on television shows, that it is possible to balance an egg like this only during the spring equinox. Now, if you don't know what the spring equinox is, it happens on March 21st, and it's not really the first day of spring so much as the day when we have equal day and night. You might have noticed in the summer the days get longer and the winter they get shorter. Well, the spring equinox is when the hours of daylight are exactly half and half. You get 12 hours of day and 12 hours of night. And there's another equinox on the other end of the calendar during the fall when we have equal hours of day and night also, and that happens right around my birthday on September 21st. So here's the idea. The idea is that something special is happening to gravity on this day, and it's allowing you to balance an egg only on that day. Now, there's something appealing about this idea, right? If you don't stop and think about it too much, you might say, wow, that's really cool, especially if you go and balance an egg on that day and it balances like this one has. And I did this. I remember being a kid and I heard this on the news. There was actually a weather guy who was doing a weather report and he explained it. He was like, yeah, and you know, it's a special day, it's an equinox, you can go ahead and balance an egg. So I ran right to the refrigerator and I started balancing eggs. And lo and behold, they balanced. And I was very excited. And it was years later, after I became a science teacher, when I stopped and thought about it scientifically and I realized, wait a minute, what is special about an equinox? Well, it has nothing to do with gravity. Equinoxes are about hours of day and night. So yes, the Earth is at a certain point in its rotation around the Sun, like we showed in that picture. It's in those positions at the top and the bottom. So yeah, I mean, I guess you could say that the Earth and Sun are in a special alignment, but gravity's not changing. We're not getting further or closer to the Sun. There's no special pull going on that day. So why would this be a special occasion? And actually, it's not. You can balance an egg on any day. You just need a steady hand and patience to do it. And if you're at home right now, this is where you would pause the tutorial and run to your refrigerator and try and balance an egg. But get permission from your parents first, because when you break the egg all on the ground, I don't want your parents calling me and complaining about it. However, it is a fun thing to do. Okay, let's assume you're back from doing that. This egg misconception was widespread in the 70s and 80s. It's starting to die back now, but so you may not have heard of it, but it was something that people just automatically believed because it sounds true. It almost sounds scientific-y, right? Oh yeah, it has to do with the equinox. That's a big fancy word, right? But it was a misconception. In reality, the egg can balance on any day. So when you stop and use the scientific method, you can figure out that this can't possibly be true. What the people who were running this experiment were failing to do was they were failing to have a control egg. They were doing an experimental egg. They had an experimental egg that they were balancing on the equinox. But they didn't try it on another day to see if, well, maybe can we balance eggs on any day? And so the scientific method helps you prevent the development of misconceptions. Here's another one of my favorite misconceptions. This one is the one that says that toilet bowls flush one way in the northern hemisphere and the other way in the southern hemisphere because of the Coriolis effect. The Coriolis effect is a real thing. It actually causes hurricanes, and it causes airplanes and other things that travel long distances to have to change the way that they fly in order to make sure they get where they're trying to go. However, it does not affect things as small as your toilet bowl. In order for water or wind to be swirled, like it is in the picture on the bottom right, it has to be covering a huge distance over the surface of the earth. And the distance from one end of your toilet bowl to the other is not big enough for the Coriolis effect to start swirling it. All the swirling that happens in your toilet bowl is actually due to the jets and the way that they're pointing and the shape of the hole in your toilet bowl. And that just is how it's manufactured. So it's not true that toilets flush one way in Australia and another way here. But it's a pretty common misconception, especially it's very appealing to people because when you hear the word Coriolis and the words Coriolis effect, you're thinking, wow, that's got to be scientific. There's got to be proof of that. And I've even seen science teachers teach that the Coriolis effect affects your toilet bowl because they've been fooled by the misconception. So you might be wondering, what's the point of bringing up these wrong ideas, Mrs. Jacuzzi? Well, I'll tell you. It's because I want you to understand that throughout the year, as we learn new science concepts, you are going to develop misconceptions. It's going to happen. It happens to everybody. You're going to have wrong ideas about things because your brain is designed to think about things a certain way. And only with careful consideration and walking through all the steps of the scientific method, making sure you run a fair test, using logic and evidence, that's the only way you can truly overcome misconceptions. And it's not easy to do, and it requires a good teacher and a good student to come together and work together to overcome those misconceptions. And I'm going to teach you as we go along to keep your eyes open for misconceptions, because that's the only way you ever get rid of them, is if you admit you have them. And believe me, you have them. Everybody does. So don't worry about the misconceptions, but make sure that you're doing a good job of protecting yourself against forming new ones and trying to root out the ones that you do have. In class, we're going to do a little mini project where you're going to investigate a misconception and then report on it to the class. And you can make one of these tutorials if you want, or you can do a poster, or you can do a live presentation. And we'll talk more about that when I see you. Okay, see you in class, guys.